today is revolution is the solution.
All right.
What's my subject?
Revolution is the solution.
You're not scared to say it, are you? What's the subject?
Revolution is the solution.
Some of y'all look like you just like you scared to say it, or you afraid that it will happen.
Uh-oh.
Revolution is the solution. Well, if revolution is the solution, then what is revolution?
All right.
Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad says that revolution is complete constructive change. What is it?
Complete constructive change.
Revolution is complete constructive change. Whether it be political revolution, complete constructive change in the politics. If it is an economic revolution, complete constructive change. If it's a spiritual revolution, if it's an emotional revolution, if it's an educational revolution, if it's a personal revolution, revolution is complete constructive change. The Bible reads in this manner, in as it was in the beginning, so shall it be in the end. As it was in the beginning, so shall it be in the ending. A revolution starts at a particular point in the beginning, and a revolution goes 360 degrees back to that original point. Well, now, what was going on in the beginning?
All right.
Were we integrated with white folks? Were we hanging out with Susie Runwickle and Bob and Bill and Merv and Doug and Douglas Fairbanks? Were we hanging out with them? Were they even on our planet is the question. In the beginning, you ruled, black man. In the beginning, you ruled, black woman. You do not have a goddamn revolution. If you stop somewhere in the middle, it must go 360 degrees. I'm talking about Old Testament Malcolm X.
Right.
Now, we got Old Testament Malcolm, and we got New Testament Malcolm.
Right.
I can't get with New Testament Malcolm, but I love Old Testament.
Yes, sir.
Old Testament Malcolm X said, a revolution is bloody.
Mm-hmm.
He said, a revolution knows no compromise.
Right.
He said, a revolution uproots and overturns everything that gets in its path.
Right.
He said, why, if you knew what a revolution was, why, you get back in the attic. If you knew what a revolution was, Malcolm said, why, you wouldn't even use, some of you wouldn't even use that word in your vocabulary.
Right.
A revolution is bloody. A revolution uproots and overturns everything that gets in its path. A revolution is complete constructive change. Everybody under the sound of my voice is a revolutionary by nature. For every physical law, there's a mental and a spiritual counterpart. As below, so as above. And as above, so as beneath. There's the exoteric, which is the surface meaning, and then there's the esoteric, which is the hidden spiritual meaning. What do we mean that everyone under the sound of my voice is a revolutionary by nature? Revolution is not something that you need to be afraid of.
Right.
The last poet said, niggas are scared of revolution. I don't know why niggas are afraid of revolution. The last poet said, niggas are afraid of revolution. But not black men, not black women, not the gods and goddesses of the original black nation. We're talking about niggas are scared of revolution. We must make a distinction between the nigger, the negro, the colored, the African-American, and all of these other half-baked, half-fried, punkified, sissified, pasteurized, homogenized labels that the white man has put on us. Revolution is the solution.
All right.
Everyone under the sound of my voice, I repeat, is a revolutionary by nature. Look at it for what it's worth. We were in our mother's womb, most of us, for approximately approximately 9 long months. It was long for mother, for sure. Right. For 9 months. And while we were in the womb of mother, there was no chance of us, except under special circumstances and C-section and other natural forms of birth, had been thwarted in some way. But under normal circumstances, we are there for approximately what?
9 months.
9 months. But before we can come to birth, a revolution must take place. Our head is at the top, our feet are at the bottom, but before we can come to birth, the water must burst. There must be blood somewhere in right. that process, right. and the baby must take a turn and make a revolution inside of mother. And after the revolution, then the baby's head comes to the mouth of the womb, that's it right. crowns. And then after the revolution inside of mother, the baby comes to birth. Mm. It makes no difference how big mother is and how small the baby is. It makes no difference how seemingly significant mother's presence is and how to the unwise and the fool, seemingly insignificant, that which we cannot see, the life of the baby is. It makes no difference that mother is independent and the baby is connected to mother, dependent on the system and the life force of mother. Regardless to how big she is, regardless to how strong she is, regardless to how powerful she is, regardless to how independent she is, that little baby, because freedom is a law of nature.
Right.
Justice is deeply rooted in the universal order of things. When 9 months roll around, no matter how big, how strong, how independent mother is, nature and the God of nature forces mother to lie down and give that baby up. It makes no difference how big America is, whether it is ruled by Bush, whether it is ruled by a whore named Gore, whether it is ruled by Clinton. It makes no difference how powerful America is, how big, how mighty, how strong, how wrong.
That's right.
Because freedom is a law of nature.
Right.
It has now come to the time when you must be free, black man and black woman, for a revolution must take place inside of America. And the black baby, the black nation, must take a turn, must make a change. And the heads of the black men and women will be crowned then. And we will burst forth from the darkness of slavery, suffering, and death of the white man into the manifest light of the sun of freedom and independence, liberation, and salvation.
All right.
Revolution is the solution.
Everybody can't, if I haven't said it, compromise. Somebody has to be strong. I wouldn't have to be as strong as I am if I saw some others being strong like that. I could tone down, but I'm feeling such desperation to get the message out, to try to plant the seed in those who are strong enough that the walls of their heart, the walls of the uterus of their minds, metaphorically speaking, can hold that revolutionary life and not abort it. So I'm not looking for great crowds. Most of the great crowd, you can get a great crowd. Well, a million will show up if you're compromising on the principle. If you're telling them, as I heard some rappers and some musicians say, I'm going to the Million Family March, they said. I went to the Million Man March, and I did too. And they said, I'm going to the Million Family March because this time is for everybody. So they were happy that white folks were being included. But they now never have anything where the white man is included. Alton Maddox is not at the slave theater right now, because Alton Maddox says that what I'm doing is for the African. What I'm doing is for the black man and black woman. No white folks, they came to the door, they tried to get in, they criticized him for having me there, everything. They tried to take him to court, and the old Negro judge out there that owned the slave theater ended up putting Attorney Maddox out because he wouldn't let white folks in. there must be some place where white folks can't come. Now, white folks, we can't keep them out of here. This is Harriet Tubman. This is school. If they came in here, if they can sit under the fire that I'll put on their behind, they're welcome. Yeah, but when they come, I ain't changing nothing for them. If anything, it's going to get hotter and harder because I got examples to point to sitting in the audience. I many times drew them right in on them. Sitting right in the audience. Look at that old ugly beast sitting there. Look at the way he's squirming. White folks, I say, should never be able to come into a black revolutionary meeting and be comfortable. And be comfortable. They shouldn't be comfortable. They should be uncomfortable. So I'm that one. It closes doors in my face. It cuts back on money that could go in my pocket. It drives some women away from me. I had some sisters I was trying to talk to, and they were really, I thought it was really, you know, something. We talking, and the sisters, none of those sisters, some of you know, one of the sisters is a singer, and this is a singer. That's all I didn't say, an actor, I said a singer. And I thought we were going out, this is some few years back. I was all excited. I heard the girl sing. I thought we were going out, and as soon as we about to make it, to go out. She honestly, as God is my witness, said to me, I found out who you are, really. She said, I can't go out with you. She said, I'm not running. She said, I might get killed if I go out with you. Do you want me to die with you? This is the truth. So, I mean, all of that is a part of it. I've been to Mecca 7 times. So you ain't got to wait for me to come back and tell you that I had no change of heart because of some crackers over in Mecca. I've already been 7 times, and I'm hard on them every time I come back because I found racism in Mecca. So I ain't coming back telling you that I'm changed because of some crackers I saw in Mecca. I ain't going to change because of no communist cracker, no socialist cracker, no soda cracker, or Nabisco cracker. No cracker is going to change. So, brother, if they stay away from me, they stay away. If the black nationalists, if the pan-Africanists, if these other radical organizations, for certain reasons, pull back from me and I look up and they ain't with me no more, I don't give a damn. I love them still, but I keep on pushing because somebody has to hold the line. And I'm going to hold the line. So back against the wall on the 1-inch line, I'm holding the line. Four downs down, and I'm still holding the line. You ain't going in, cracker. You're not going in. Somebody has to do that. I'm comfortable uncompromising. I understand I'm not going to be invited to this or that or this. Somebody has to do it.